Sydney's bike lanes have been widely panned as roads to nowhere.
But Lord Mayor Clover Moore remains defiant, saying the number of morning cyclists has increased by 60%.
Traditionally, Sydney's cyclists have sported chiselled calves, lycra-clad limbs and a determined demeanour. But cycling is changing. These days, riders come in all shapes and sizes and they're making use of new cycle paths across Sydney.
The comprehensive planning and consultation has been done and 10 kilometres of separated cycleway has been done. And there are other sections now that are in the process of being constructed.
Sydney Mayor Clover Moore is responsible for the cycle lane rollout. The four-year, $76 million project is due for completion by 2013. On this map, the green lines represent the cycle lanes which have already been completed. The blue routes are works in progress.
Look, I think we're starting to get out of what I say the dark ages are of bicycling here.
According to the council, congestion in Sydney has a $4 billion a year price tag. Still, not everyone is in favour of the mayor's grand plans.
She's for sandal wearing, muesli chewing, bike riding, pedestrians, without any idea of the metropolitan quality of the city.
Change is often slow, and the sorts of problems that I'm being confronted with now are the ones that New York was confronted with, that Portland was confronted with.
Not surprisingly, the lanes have been well received by cyclists. Already there's been a 60% increase in morning bike traffic to the city.
What's not to like? I mean, you know, there's no reason not to really.
Fitness without taking time out of your day.
Oh, the health benefits of it. You get to from A to B a lot quicker. And yeah, it's a lot more fun.
Infrastructure is important, as is education, skills training, and just a general acceptance that cycling is a great way for those short trips. And a very large percentage of trips in Australia are below 5 kilometres.
But many are complaining bike paths are a road to nowhere.
Please be patient. You know, don't judge this until it's finished, because we have to get the connections in.
Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.